am going to explain you about oxygen administration. So before that, you have to know what is oxygen administration. So oxygen administration is a procedure through which we have to give oxygen supply to the patient who are having problem like breathing difficulty, respiratory problem, and after any surgery, patient undergoing any cardiac arrest. That's it. So now we are going to discuss about purpose of oxygen administration: to relieve the breathing difficulty, to correct the tissue hypoxia, hypoxemia, and use after the nasal or oral surgery. So indication of oxygen administrations are dyspnea, respiratory problem, myocardial infarction, major burn, shock, and anemia. So for oxygen administration, we need a tray containing or having oxygen mask and nasal drops and pulse oximeter, which is very important to check SpO2 rate during giving oxygen, and after giving also we need to check the oxygen saturation in the patient body. So we need one gauze piece to wipe oxygen mask before putting patient face. So before that, I want to clarify the part of our oxygen mask. This strip to tie the mask, and these two is inhalation port, and then half one is nasal strip, and this is tubing through which we'll connect to the oxygen cylinder. So we are having nasal prong also, and now I am going to describe the parts of our oxygen cylinder. This is oxygen cylinder. Now I am going to describe about the parts. So this one is known as pressure gauge, and this one is known as humidifier, and this one is flow meter through which we can know how much oxygen is going, and this one is regulator through which we can minimize or maximize the flow rate. So here is a connector, tube connector, where we'll connect the tube with the oxygen mask, or we can connect with the nasal prongs also. So we have to connect this one side of the tube here, and before giving this mask to the patient face, we have to maintain the flow rate. So from here we can given oxygen liter per minute, we can give 4, or if prescribed it's more than 4, then we can give like that according to the patient condition. And after that, now we have to put this mask on the patient face, and we have to check that it will connect with the patient face nicely. After that, it is very important to connect pulse oximeter to check patient oxygen saturation, but the, through that we will get to know that patient oxygen rate is patient is getting well enough oxygen or not. And after that, after half an hourly, we have to check patient vital signs like pulse rate, SpO2 and respiratory rate, and if any further complication will occur, then we can inform to the physician. It is very important to remember that during this oxygen administration, we have to put no smoking sign, because it will be dangerous for everyone if someone will smoke near the oxygen cylinder.